The state television company Western Armenia represents the most important events of these days. Today's broadcast, size of Western Armenia, the Niagara waterfall of Geyseri. Over 148 tons of various humanitarian aid arrived in Armenia with support of Hayastan Fund. Situation in Nagorno-Karabakh conflict zone remains stable. No ceasefire violations have been recorded. Maria Zakharova. Book donation day in Armenia. Putin and Erdogan discussed the situation after the Artsakh war. The Aramean College of Tabriz was founded on this day 170 years ago. Today is the day of signing of San Stefano Treaty. Armenian Virtual Observatory. Interview with Arek Mikhailian. A group of Kapuzbash waterfalls is located in Aladaglar National Park in the province of Yahyal, Kayseri, Western Armenia. The waterfalls fed by the melting of snow masses coming from above have created a fairy tale beauty. Kapuzbash waterfalls are located 190 kilometers from the center of Kayseri, consist of 7 waterfalls in an area of 500 square meters and offer their guests a visual feast even in winter. Waterfalls attract the attention of nature lovers from different places. It is worth seeing these waterfalls along with other natural beauties of Western Armenia. We recommend visiting there. Since the very beginning of the war, through the efforts of the Armenians all over the world and with the support of the Hayastan All-Armenian Fund, large-scale humanitarian aid has been sent to Armenia. To date, approximately 184,345 kilograms of rice humanitarian aid has arrived in Armenia, the fund reports. The assistance received includes modern medical equipment, first aid supplies, wound treatment and skin recovery products, warm winter clothes, shoes, sleeping bags, tents, beds, food gift packages for Artsakh school children, and so on. After the end of military actions, 33,389 kilograms of humanitarian aid arrived and was distributed directly by the fund. Most of the aid received during this period originated from Los Angeles and France. The situation in Nagorno-Karabakh conflict zone remains stable. No ceasefire violations have been recorded. As Armen Press reports, official representative of the Ministry of Foreign Affairs of Russia, Maria Zakharova, said in a weekly briefing, "In recent days, the situation in the Nagorno-Karabakh conflict zone remained stable. No ceasefire violations have been recorded. The servicemen of the Russian peacekeeping unit keep control of the situation at 27 checkpoints, clearing explosive devices and ensuring the safe return of displaced people. The work continues within the framework of a trilateral working group headed by the deputy prime ministers of Armenia, Russia and Azerbaijan. The results of the second meeting of the working group held on February 12th were reported on the website of the Russian government. In order to increase the public interest and love for books and reading, the birthday of All-Armenian poet Hovhannes Tumanyan on February 19 is Book Donation Day in Armenia. As reported by Armen Press, the holiday was rooted in Armenia on the initiative of the president of the Writers' Union, Levon Ananyan, since 2008. Within the framework, many events are held in the capital and in the regions of Armenia. Russian President Vladimir Putin had a telephone conversation with Turkish President Recep Tayyip Erdogan. The leaders of Russia and Turkey discussed a number of regional issues, as well as the steps aimed at developing bilateral relations during the telephone conversation. The parties discussed the Artsakh issue and the work of the Russian-Turkish Monitoring Center located in Akhna. The Aramean school was founded on February 19, 1851, in the yard of the church in the Gala district of Tabriz on the initiative of Bishop Sahak Satunyan. Until 1875, it was called Narsisyan, later was called Aramean after the Iranian-Armenian philanthropist. At first, it was a boys' school. In 1887, joined the girls' school Annayan, built with the help of the Tumanyans, and became bisexual and was called the Aramean Annayan National School. In 1852, the school had 60 students, the next year 100. Later, the number of students reached from 240 to 260. Armenian, Russian, French, Persian, and other subjects were taught. The teaching was in Armenian. The first inspector of the school was prized Father Hovsep. It operated until 1936. Aramean school has done a great job in the field of enlightenment of Persian Armenians. The school has given about 1,300 graduates since 1936. Rafin Terachajaryan taught in Aramean school. Treaty of San Stefano, a preliminary peace treaty signed in the San Stefano suburb of Constantinople on February 19, 1878. Ending the Russian-Turkish War of 1877 to 1878. It was of great importance in the liberation of the Balkan peoples from the Turkish yoke and in the field of international diplomacy on the Armenian issue. the provisions of the Treaty of San Stefano were revised in a document adopted as a result of the Berlin Congress. It was signed on February 19 in San Stefano. The Treaty of San Stefano guaranteed the fulfillment of the obligations undertaken by Turkey, that is, immediately implement improvements based on local needs of the Armenian-populated regions. Under the Treaty of San Stefano, Montenegro, Serbia, and Romania were recognized as independent. Bosnia and Herzegovina gained autonomy within the Ottoman Empire. Bulgaria was declared an autonomous power with the consent of the powers and the power established by the High Gate. The Turkish troops were withdrawn from Bulgaria and the Russian troops remained there for 2 years. Russia received the southern Bessarabia, which was separated from it by the Treaty of Paris in 1856, and Ardahan, Kars, Batumi, Bayazet in Asia, and the territory up to Soganluh. A special article planned administrative reforms in western Armenia. The successful course of the war for Russia and the occupation of a part of western Armenia by the Russian troops inspired liberation hopes in the Armenian political circles as well. For the first time in modern history, the name Armenia was mentioned by Armenians in an international treaty. According to Article 19 of the treaty, Kars, Ardahan, Bayazet, Batumi, Oltin, Artanuj, Ardvin, Alashkert, Gagzavan and Khumar passed to Russia. On Western Armenia TV, the director of the Burakan Observatory, Arek Mikhailian, presented the Armenian Virtual Observatory and its connection with high technologies, noting that astronomy is closely connected with computer science and it develops on the basis of large data received from space. Touching upon the connection between astronomy and military industry, he mentioned that in this war it would be very important if Armenia had at least one satellite. Space exploration and cartography were developed. In this case, even with the accuracy of one soldier, we could follow the movement of the enemy army and act accordingly. Now we present you Hars Nugem Guzem Mekmaylik by Sharakan Choir. The full version is available on the official website of Western Armenia TV. This was all for today. Goodbye.